Tasya. So of this is the essence when you said of which what is immediately mentioned, what is previously and immediately mentioned. So edasya sataha eshaha rasaha. So idi etavan matrokto avyavahita purvasya sadvisheshanasyeva grahanam bhavet. So edasya sataha eshaha saraha. Someone may think that of this which is sat or the grow or the manifest, this sun is the sara of the essence. Itaraccha agrahitameva iti avata. And so other, some may think that this is sun is an essence of only sat and not of the other three. That is what one may think. Na itaraccha agrahitameva bhavishaya bhavet visheshanam tathacha visheshana chatushtaya visheshasya karyamna siddhet. And then the sun is not then understood or is established as the effect of all these four visheshanas of the three elements. That may not get established. One may think that the sun is merely the effect of the sat or the formed aspect of the three elements. So that kind of a confusion or that kind of a conclusion may not be there. Therefore, Shruti makes it a point to mention each one of these qualifications, meaning thereby that sun is the essence of, so of the three elements. Three elements possessed of grossness. Three elements possessed of mortality. Three elements possessed of the limitation. Three elements possessed of the formness. So, three elements possessed of all these four aspects, they go into making up what we call the sun. And not just one of the aspects. That's all. Therefore, in order to establish the sun is the final product of these three elements, including all the four aspects, the Shruti makes it a point to repeat etasya murtasya etasya martasya etasya sthitasya etasya sataha. This way, that's called anuvada. So ityaha Bhashyakara says tasya etasya murtasya etasya martasya etasya sthitasya etasya sataha chatushtaya visheshanasya bhutatrayasya ityarthaha tasya etasya murtasya. As you say, of this that is gross, of that same thing which is perishable, that which is limited, and that which is formed, chatushtaya visheshanasya bhutatrayasya, the three elements each possessed of this fourfold aspects. So of this eshaha sara, of this three elements possessed of the four aspects, this sun is sara, the essence. Says Bhashyakara, eshaha sara eshaha rasaha saraha ityarthaha. Of these three elements, this is the eshaha. Who is eshaha? Savita, footnote 5. Then mandalam iti avad. This sun is the saraha. So rasaha means saraha. Rasa and sara is one. Rasa means essence. Sara also means the very essence. Of them, this is the essence. So these three elements have formed what we call the sun. So this becomes the most excellent product or the essence of them. So whatever is the best that the three elements have to offer, that best that the three elements have to offer has gone into making what we call the solar orb. Saratvam sadhat. How do you say that this sun is sara, the essence of the three elements? How do you say that? Sadhayati Vashyakara establishes that trayanam hi bhutanam sarishtha savita. Trayanam hi bhutanam sarishtha savita. He, because trayanam bhutanam, the three elements, sarishtha saratam savita, the surya mandalam. So this solar orb is the saratam, the most excellent essence of these three elements. This is pratignya. This is what it is so. Why is it so? So tatra pratignya manudya hetumaha. Bhashyakara again reiterates the pratignya proposition and gives the hetu, the reason why is it so. Etat sarani kreeni bhutani यतः एतत् कृतः विभज्यमानः रूपविशेषणानि भवन्ति। एतत् साराणि त्रीणि भूतानि। सो एतत् साराणि, फुट नंबर 8 इज बहुव्रीहिः। एतत् साराणि त्रीणि, एतत् मीन्स व्हाट? सूर्य मंडलम। सो दिस थ्री एलिमेंट, त्रीणि भूतानि, द थ्री एलिमेंट्स हैव एतत् सार, मीनिंग हैव द एसेंस इन एतत् और सूर्य मंडल। सो सूर्य मंडल इज द वेरी एसेंस ऑफ द थ्री एलिमेंट्स। Somebody says, wait a minute, you say that the creation actually is a product of five elements. Where do you get three elements? So footnote number 9, they have to connect every Upanishad with every other Upanishad, you know. So this Upanishad doesn't seem to be bothered about five elements and three elements. And so here, it seems to say that this universe that is manifest is a product of three elements. But we understand that it is actually a product of five elements. So footnote number 9 says, Bhutadvaya Upasarjanani. In fact, five elements are there. Of these, three elements are the predominance. So three elements, five elements in which three elements are predominance, the other two elements are not predominant, therefore they are not mentioned. So when you actually do the vyavahara with the world, what are the elements that are evident? The fire, water and earth. The air and space are there, but then in vyavahara, they do not seem to play a great role. That's why it's a shraddhamayoyam purusha. This person is nothing but his Shraddha. That means when you actually interact with a person, what is the most predominant aspect of the person that is evident is Shraddha. Meaning whatever he believes in, whatever he values, etc., that alone actually becomes evident, you know, when you interact with the person. That's why you say he is nothing but his Shraddha. Other aspects are there. But then what is evident, what plays the most predominant or dominant role is this Shraddha. Similarly also, what is dominantly evident are these three elements. Bhutadva upasarjanani. Upasarjanani means gaunani. Mandalarambhe trayanam pradhanyat mandalasya panchaka karyatvat. So, in creation forming of the mandala, these three have predominance, even though the mandala, meaning the solar orb, is a product of five elements, these three elements have a predominant role. So, going back to Bhashya, etat sarani, trini bhutani. Again, trini footnote number 10, same thing. Trini bhutani di bhutadve upasarjanani tan mandalarambhe svam pradhanani di avada tasya mandalasyabhi pancha bhutatmakatva. Same thing. That means the mandala is actually made of five elements, but the three elements are predominant in there. That is the pratignya part. Etas sarani trini bhutani. Then hetu is what? Yataha, because etat krita vivajyamana rupa visheshanani bhavanti. Because we find that the three elements, actually sun is the principle of light, and light elements colors. So light is actually colors. So how do you know the three elements? So Chandogya Upanishad says how the three elements are actually distinguished by their colors. So the element fire, the color is red. The element water, the color is white. The element earth, the color is black. Wherever you see red color, understand that is the element fire. Wherever you see white color, understand element water. So that's why the children are asking me, but this is all red color, you know. This color always shows caution, you know. How come Swamiji are wearing this? It's not red, I said, it's orange. But anyway, a lot of redness is there, you know. I guess that's caution. So Bada Swamiji used to say that Brahmachari Diksha was given, you know, to the Brahmachari at the end of the conclusion of the course. So Bada Swamiji will say that we are giving this yellow for the sake of people so that they will be cautioned, you know. And so they will know what not to do with this person and whatever, you know. So to caution them, whatever it is. But anyway, so wherever you see red, understand that is fire. Wherever you see white, understand that is water. Wherever you see black, understand that is earth. So Chandogya Upanishad spends 15 hours in saying this. Shows everywhere. So in Aditya and the Surya, so that which is the lohitam rupam, yad adityasya lohitam rupam tad agnehe rupam. So the redness that you see in the sun, understand that is due to fire. The whiteness that is shuklam rupam, you see the white form, the color, understand that belongs to the water. Yad krishnam rupam, So that which you see the black color, they must be seeing it in some way. So the black color that is seen in Aditya, understand that that is due to the earth. And then we'll show everything in the world. Lightning also, stars also, earth also, everywhere, wherever you see these three colors. Or the combination. Sometimes you see a pigeon or a dove like that. You don't see distinct color like red, etc. Understand that that's a combination of these three colors. Although we thought that lal, pirone, vadari. So this red, yellow and what is it? And blue are considered the basic colors. But here they say the red, white and black. So everything is a combination of these three. And therefore the play of the three elements is what we see everywhere. So universe is what? The play of the three elements. It's a play of three colors. And how do the elements possess the colors? Because sun illumines them. So the sun possesses the principle of color. Principle of light is a principle of color, which comes from these three elements. All the three elements also get distinguished from one another because they possess distinct colors which are illumined by the sun.
So yatah etat krita vibhajyamana roopa visheshani bhavanti shukla krishna adirupani aditya seva.
So these three colors, the white, black and red, are they belong to sun. Tatkratayeva bhedaha, only therefore the sun actually distinguishes by red, giving red color, imparting a white color or black color. So roopa visheshani bhavanti, in short, these three elements become distinguished from one another because they possess colors. Which color says the principle? That is what we call the sun, because principle of light and principle of color is one alone. Because light and color, they always go together. Without light, you can't perceive the color. You can see how what subtle thinking is there, you know. So this is how the whole universe is very beautifully analyzed. Even to know this itself is nice, good thing. And so when we see the play, actually in fact what they are doing is showing a certain harmony that obtains in all this diversity of names and forms. That's the reason why we are given this model of five elements. That we find all these objects of the world all distinct from one another. Each one standing distinctly and apart from others, it appears. But it's not so, there is a harmony. That they're all made up of five elements, or three elements, or three colors. And thus, each object is nothing but a play of the three colors. You can see that play. An artist can see the play of the colors everywhere. And these colors are the elements. And these elements, the essence of them is the sun. So sun is the principle of light, and therefore is the essence of the color. And so that which distinguishes, the illumines the distinct colors. That's how one can see the universe. That's how one can grow out of or overcome the distinctions. So distinctions are fine. They have their own place. But at the same time, it is necessary to know that in and through the distinctions also, there is a common or a basic substratum. That is what we call a common element in there. That is what also is being shown here. That's what Anandagiri says. Etena. So, etat krita vibhajyamana roopa visheshanani. Anandagiri explains that expression. Etena savitrumandalena kritani vibhajyamanani asankirnani krishnam shruklam lohitamiti etani rupani visheshanani yesham prithivyaptejasam tani ratha. So etena savitrumandalena, by this savitamandal, meaning the orb of the sun, kritani vibhajyamanani asankirnani. It is the sun that actually brings to light the colors as distinct from one another. Krishnam, Shuklam, Lohitam, the black, white and red. Iti etani rupani visheshanani yetha yesham. And these colors actually are the distinguishing characteristics of the three elements. As we said, the fire is distinguished by the color red, the water distinguished by the color white, and earth distinguished by the color black. And inasmuch as the sun brings to distinction these three colors and therefore enables one to recognize these three elements, that is why we say that the sun is the sara or the essence. Or footnote number 18 also said. Etena bhutatraya rupanam krishnadinam सवितृमण्डले असङ्कीर्णतया प्रतीयमानत्वात् तस्य भूतत्रय सारत्वमिति भावः. ओय कैसे भूतत्रय रूपाणां कृष्णादीनां. सो दिस थ्री इज ए भूतत्रय, द थ्री एलिमेंट्स पोजेसिंग रेड व्हाइट एंड ब्लैक कलर्स सवितृमण्डले असङ्कीर्णतया प्रतीयमानत्वात्. So we see all the three colors very distinctly in the solar orb. Only in the morning you see the red color, in the evening you see the red color, in the hot afternoon you see the white color, and then some point in time you might see the black color, I don't know. And so since these three colors you see in the sun, therefore we say that. So tasya bhutatra saratvam. So therefore this solar orb is the sara, the essence of the three elements. And again, so Anandagrita Tataha Bhutatraya Karya Madhye Savitra Mandarasya Pradhanyam Ityartaha Tataha. Again, footnote 19, Bhutatraya Rupanam Swasmin Vispashtam Adarshakatvat. So, since Sun within himself Adarshakatvat shows the Bhutatrayanam, so Swasmin, see the forms, the colors of these three elements, the sun actually very clearly shows within himself the colors pertaining to these three elements, and therefore we say that the sun is the product of the three elements. Element is color. That's how also the sattva, rajas and tamas. Sattva also is white, rajas is red, tamas is black. And so where the element fire is there, there is going to be rajas because red color. Where the element water is there, there is going to be sattva, I guess, you know. Where the element earth is there, there is tamas. So too much earth in the body, tamas. Water, lightness, sattva. And red, fire is all pittam, is all, you know, so kama, krodha, lobha. Kapha, vata, pitta. Sattva, rajas, tamas. Fire, water, earth. So this is a beautiful model. That's how either model of five elements or model of three elements also goes very well. It is not that this model is arbitrary. So people used to think that these five elements are arbitrary. It's not arbitrary. It has much to do with our personality and our experiences also. It is not scientific in a manner of, you know, that they are not distinct, different from each other. But then their effects are all very distinct in our body and our personality and the universe that we come across. In that sense, this model of three elements is a very, very useful and very practical model, or the model of five elements. So says again Anandagiri, Tataha Bhutatraya Karya Madhye Savitra Mandalasya Pradhana Mityartha. In short, the three elements have given, produced this whole universe. Of them, the souls, the sun is the most predominant, meaning the most excellent essence of the three elements. That's the idea here. Okay, we'll continue tomorrow.
Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah Ishvaro Guru Ratmedi Murti Bheda Vibhagine Vyoma Vadhyapta Dehaya Dakshina Murtaye Namah. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namah. Hari Om.
Avabrahmana Rupe Murtam Chaiva Murtam Cha Martyam Cha Amrutam Cha Sthitam Cha Yachya Satchatyachya Tadetan Murtam Yadanyadvayos Chantarikshachya एतन्मर्त्यम् एतत्स्थितम् एतत्सत् तस्यैतस्य मूर्तस्य एतस्य मर्त्यस्य एतस्य स्थितस्य एतस्य सतः एष रसः य एष तपते सतो ह्येष रसः तदेतत् मूर्तम्. सो दिस् इस् दि मूर्तम् दैट् विच् इस् ग्रोस् यद् वायोः अन्तरिक्षाचन्यम् of the five elements, this is called Murtam of the gross, which is different from the Vayu and Antariksha, the air and the space, meaning the three remaining elements, the fire, water and earth, is called Murtam. They are called gross because they are perceptible to the eyes. Etan Martyam, Etasthitam, Etatsat. Indeed, this is Martyam, this is mortal or perishable. Etasthitam, it is Parichinnam, limited in space. Etatsat, it is formed, it is manifest or the effect. Tasya etasya murtasya, etasya martyasya, etasya sthitasya, etasya sataha. Of that, of these three elements, each one of which has this qualification that it is gross and that it is perishable and that it is limited in place and that it is perishable or formed. So, of these three elements which possess, each one of which possesses this fourfold attributes or qualifications or characteristics. Eshaha rasaha. From these three elements is made this, the rasaha here is the very essence. The essence of the most excellent product of these three elements is ya eshaha tapade. It is the sun that shines. Satohi esha rasaha. Because the sun, meaning the orb of the sun, the solar orb, which is a visible thing, is indeed the rasaha, the essence of the three elements. This is what is said. So as we said, the sun stands for the cosmic, the cosmos, where the orb of the sun stands for the body, and the person in the sun stands for the subtle body, and the consciousness in the sun stands for the universal consciousness. So this is in the context of Adhidaiva, in the context of the, in the divine context. Similar thing will be stated with reference to individual context, Adhyatma also. There is corresponding so features in the individual also, the features which are there in the universe, in the cosmos. So there is a gross body, and controlling that gross body is a subtle body, and envisioning even the subtle body is the consciousness. Just as in a fan, there are these blades, and rotating the blades are the motors, and then again energizing the motor is the electricity, and similarly also the self, that is consciousness, then energizes the subtle body, which in turn enlivens the gross body. That the gross body is said to be here made up of five elements, of which the three elements are predominant. The subtle body also is made up of five elements, of which two elements are predominant. So the idea is, the gross body is not just the product of three elements, it is product of all the five elements, except that the three elements, the gross three elements, the fire, water and earth, are predominant. And the subtle body also is composed of the five elements, however, in that the space and the air are predominant. And also the Shruti wants to make sure that each one of these, all these four go together like the four legs of a cart. So if you pull one, other three automatically get pulled. And similarly also these four qualifications always go together. One is not independent of the other, each one presupposes the other. Therefore each one is because the other is, and the other is because the one is. And so these elements are called gross because they are perishable. Why are they perishable? Because they are limited in place. Why are they limited in place? Because they are manifest or formed. Because they possess a form, therefore they are limited in a place, and therefore they are perishable, and therefore they are gross. So you can go the other way around also. They are gross, and therefore they are perishable, and therefore limited in a place, and therefore formed. So this anyonya, hetu hetu mat bhava. or Karyakaran Bhava or Visheshana Vishesha Bhava. Each one becomes the qualification for the other. Each one becomes the cause for the other. So going to page 544. So tasya etasya murtasya etasya martyasya etasya sthitasya etasya sataha. So all these four have been specifically mentioned just to make a point that what we call the cosmic body, the cosmic gross body, is a product of all these four aspects of the three elements and not just one of them. So therefore all the four are mentioned here. Chatushta visheshanasya bhutatrayasya ityartha. Bhutatrayasya, the three elements, the fire, water and earth, each one of them possessed of this fourfold qualifications. Eshaha saraha rasaha saraha ityartha. So eshaha savitru mandalam. And so this mandalam, the orb of the sun, is saraha, is the essence of these three elements. All the four phases or aspects of the three elements go into making up of what we call the solar orb, which is the cosmic body. As we said, the sun symbolizes the cosmos. Sun is an excellent symbol of the cosmos. As all the forms have ultimately culminated into creating that form. And whatever there is in this creation, the essence of it, the most excellent of it, is to be found in the sun. एषः सार रसः सारः इत्यर्थः त्रयाणां विभूतानां सारिष्ठः सविता. He because Savita, the sun, meaning here the Savitra Mandalam, the orb of the sun, because the sun also is then is understood as consisting of three aspects. One is the orb of the sun that is evident. Second is the person, the subtle body which is there, which is not evident but which is there. And third, the consciousness that is, that even makes a subtle body and live. So here what is meant by Savita is the solar orb. Sarishtha saratamah, that means the most excellent product, you can say, or that very best effect or the product of the three elements is the sun. Edat sarani trini bhutani. Edat sarani, say that meaning this Savita, Sarha, Yesham, Tani, Etat Sarani. So this sun is the Sara, the essence of which three elements, those three elements. Yataha, Etat Krita, Vivajjamana Rupa Visheshanani Bhavanti. Because how do we distinguish the three? Even the, for us to be able to distinguish the fire from water and water from earth, how do we do that? We are able to distinguish them by their colors actually. That fire is red and water is white and the earth is black. So how are we able to do that? Because the sun enables us to do that. So sun enables us really to, it imparts or it illumines their colors, and thus the distinction between them can be recognized by us. Etat krita vibhajyamana rupa visheshanani. So vibhajyamana rupa, each one of the elements has its own rupa or color. And it is the sun because of which those colors are distinctly recognized. And that's why we say that the three elements correspond to the sun. And so the colors which is there in the three elements have gone into making up of the sun. That's the idea. That the red, white and the black colors which belong to the three elements have then combined and the essence has gone into making up of what we call sun. Okay, now continuing with the Bhashya. So, Sri Anandri, Etena Savitramandalena Kritani Vivajyamanani Asankinani Krishnam Shuklam Lohidam Idi Etani Rupani. That we are able to Asankinani, meaning without any confusion or mixing up, we are able to recognize that this is red, this is black, this is white. How are we able to recognize it? Because they are illumined by sun. Krishnam Shuklam Lohidamiti Etani Rupani Visheshanani Yesham Prithviyap Tejasam. So Prithvi has Krishnam up, Shuklam Tejas Lohitam. And that is how Pusvyaptesam. So the compound is like that. That's why also Krishnam, otherwise a Krama should have been the Lohitam Shuklam Krishnam. But it, or a Krishnam Shuklam Lohitam also is okay. So Pusvyaptesam Tani. So thus, that is why we say that the sun is the very essence of the three elements. There is a correspondence. There is a correspondence between the sun and the three elements. Three elements means three colors. And those colors correspond to the sun because they are illumined by the sun. In turn, they make up the sun. Then Annigiri says, in the fourth line, Yeye Shatapati iti asya arthamaha. Yeye Shatapati. So, it was said, etasya sataha eshaha rasaha. Yesha tapati. So of these three elements, possessed of these four qualifications, what is the rasa? The one that shines. So who is that? Says Vashagara. Adhidaivikasya karyasya etadrupam yat savita yadetan mandalam tapati. Adhidaivikasya. Footnote Trayanam Bhutanam Visheshaha. Trayanam Bhutanam Adhidaivikasya Karyasya. So again, these three elements that we have, let's say five elements really, even when they say three elements, we should understand them as five elements, in which three elements are predominant. So these five elements give rise to two kinds of effects or products. One is adhyadevika, one is the cosmic level, other is adhyatmika, one other than the individual level. So five elements give rise to the whole cosmos as well as they give rise to the individual. So therefore adhyadevika and adhyatmika, that's how we find. Themselves are adhibhautika. So bhutas are adhibhautika, giving rise to adhyadevika and adhyatmika. So trayanam bhutanam Adhidaivikasya, karyasya, etadrupam. That the three elements are given rise to this cosmic effect. And that karya, the effect is etadrupam yat savita. So this is the rupa, this is a form that they have given rise, and that is savita, that is the surya, the sun. So eshaha, you know, eshaha, because it's interesting how the Shruti does not mention the word sun, you know. Because it says, Yaesha tapati, the one that shines, so we understand it to be sun. But Yaesha, Esha is masculine. And therefore, it is Savita. Savita means Surya, the sun. Savita is a masculine word. Although we in Gujarati, Savita means, is a feminine name for us. But in Sanskrit, it is masculine word. Here, of course, whatever ends, Savita is a nominative singular of Savitru. And anything that ends with A, you know, would be feminine, that's okay. So Savita is masculine. Esha Savita. And therefore, but what should we understand by the word sun? So Vashyakara says, Yadetan Mandalam Tapati. This is footnote number 13. Tasya Chetana Vishetvamashankya Yadetat. So Savita is masculine. So person, and so we would imagine that it's a conscious entity that is being referred to by the word Savita. But now, Yadetat Mandalam. So that which is the orb of the sun, that is what is meant here. So since Shruti uses the word Esha, which is masculine, therefore Bhashyakara has to give an explanation that what is meant by the word sun is the mandala, this the orb of the sun. Yadetat Mandalam Tapati. Shashvat Vishwamidishesha. Always, all the time, illumines the creation. Hetu Vakyam Adaya Tasya Tatparyamaha. Says Anandagiri, Hetu Vakyam. Esha Shabdena Mandalapaligahe Yad Hetu Vakyam Tat. So, how come by the word Eshaha we understand the Surya, the sun? So by the word Eshaha, which is a pronoun, anything it can, you know, it can mean anything. how is it that we interpret the pronoun eshah, that this as the sun? Because, so, eshah tapati. No, satohi eshah rasah. That is the hetu. The reason why we say that there is sun is because satah. So, Bhashyakara says, the reason why we interpret the word eshah as sun is because satohi eshah rasah, that is hetu, the reason for it is given by Shruti herself, which Bhashyakara explains. Satah bhutatrayasya hi yasmat esha rasah ityetat grihyate. Satah, footnote number 15, visheshanantaropalakshanamidam. Satah, although Shruti mentions only one, Satah, one Visheshanam Sat, we should also understand what? We should also understand the Murtam, and then Martyam, and then Sthitam, and Sat. So all the four we should understand. Visheshanantara Upalakshanam. So one Visheshana Sat is mentioned for these gross elements, the other three Visheshanas also should be understood as included. So Satah, Bhutatrayasya, of the three elements which thus possesses fourfold aspects, he because yasmad eshah rasah, because this sun is the rasah, the essence of these three elements, the four aspects of all the three elements. Idi etad grihyate. So says esha shabdasya chetana vishayatma ashankya etad iti. Again, esha is interpreted as etad. Grishyade pratyaksham upalabhyade. So that which is perceived immediately, which is the sun, orb of the sun, is what is understood to be, so the what is understood to be indicated or mentioned by the word, meant by the word, eshah. Mandala parigraha hetumaha. Why do even in the sun, all eshah is savita, but when you say savita, why do you say that it is only mandalam and not the one within savita? So, Murtohi, Bhashyakara says, Murtohi Esha Savita Tapati. So, one that shines is the gross. It is the gross or the evident or the manifest sun that shines, you know. That is why we say that it is the manifest aspect of the sun, or the gross, visible, experiential aspect of the sun. That is what is meant by, because the three elements are like that. The three elements are gross and those which can be perceived by the sense organs. Therefore, that aspect of the sun which is perceived by the sense organs must be the essence of this. Of these three elements again, or the five elements, there is a subtle aspect also. So of the five elements, the gross aspect is what we experience. Therefore, the sun, which aspect of sun which we experience, must be the corresponding aspect. And of the five elements also, there is an aspect that we do not experience, meaning which is subtle. So they should go into making up the subtle aspect of the sun. So gross aspect of the five elements should make up the gross or visible aspect. The subtle aspect of the five elements should go into making up the subtle aspect. So karya and karana. Karya means gross body, karana means subtle body.
Sitanagiri murtagrahanasya upalakshanatva chaturnam anvayah hetvartha. Murtagrahanasya upalakshanatvat. Murtohi esha savita tapati. So upalakshanatvat chaturnam anvayah hetvartha. Chaturnam means all the four are understood to be there, you know. See, now on the footnote of page 545, footnote number 5. Chaturnam anvayaheti murta martya sthita satam anvayah sambandha. I mean, all the four should be understood to be there. Hetvartha hetu vakyasah dvartike yatha, meaning that's the murto hi esha, no, sato hi esha rasah, that's a hetu vakya. He means because, so because this savita is rasa, the essence of this sat, and so that's a hetu vakya. And so that all the, that sat should also be understood as including the other three. So murta, martya, sthita, satam, anvaya, sambandha, all the four should be understood to be there. Vartike yatha,
चतुष्टयान्वयादेशः भूतत्रयरसस्मृतः. सो चतुष्टय अन्वयाद मीन्स ऑल द फोर आर रिलेटेड इन देयर. एषः भूतत्रयरसस्मृतः. सो दिस थ्री एलिमेंट्स, फाइव एलिमेंट्स, इन विद दिस थ्री एलिमेंट्स आर प्रेडोमिनेंट द ऑल द फोर आस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ थ्री एलिमेंट्स गोइंग टू मेकिंग ऑफ द सन ऑर द ऑर्ब ऑफ द सन. चतुष्टयम् हि मूर्तादि मंडले गृह्यते यतः. Because when we perceive the sun, we perceive all the four aspects. We see the sun as cross. We see the sun as confined. We see the sun also as perishable because it is confined. We see the sun as formed. So all the four aspects are visible in the orb of the sun. Therefore we say that all the four aspects of these elements have gone into making up of the sun. Murto hi esha savita tapati. So Savita, the sun that shines, is Murtaha, is that which is Murtaha, Martyaha, and Sthitaha, and Sat. So this is what we perceive. Therefore we say that these four aspects or the three elements have gone in making up the orb of the sun. Nansidhananagiri, Atascha, Mandalatma, Savita, भूतत्रय कार्य मध्ये भवति प्रधानम् कार्यकारणयोः एकरूप्यस्य औत्सर्गत्वादित्याः. अतश्च एंड देयरफॉर आल्सो अगेन व्हाट इज अतश्च वक्ष्यमाणात् हेतोः बिकॉज़ ऑफ द रीजन दैट इज गोइंग टू स्टेटेड च अतश्च इति उक्तादेव हेतोः भूतत्रय कार्य मध्ये प्रधानम् कार्यम् प्रधान कार्य रूपः सविता मंडलात्मा एव ग्राह्यः इत्यर्थः. सी फुट नोट नंबर 8 आई एम रीडिंग. उक्तादेव हेतोः, व्हाट इज हेतु? बिकॉज दिस इज व्हाट वी फाइंड दैट व्हेन वी परसीव द सन वी परसीव ऑल दीज एस्पेक्ट्स एंड देयरफॉर भूतत्रय कार्य मध्ये प्रधानम कार्यम सविता. सो दी मे बी द थ्री एलिमेंट्स आर गिवन रेस्ट मेनी प्रोडक्ट्स ऑफ देम. The most important product or the predominant product is Savita or the sun. Mandalatma eva grahya ityartha, and that which is perceived by us, namely the mandalam, the orb, that is what is meant by the eshah, what eshah. Murta adi chaturnam anvayasya uktasya hetoho hetutve yuktimaha. So murta adi chaturnam anvayasya uktasya, that all the four must be taken, you know, the sambandha, not just one. Uktasya hetoho. So that we say that that's a hetu, that all the four are actually going to making of the sun and are perceptible. Yukti maha. So why? All right, let us say the question is, the three elements, each one of them is possessed of these four aspects, and we perceive also those four aspects in the orb of the sun. So what? What makes you think that that is why the elements have gone into making of the sun? Because kari karanayoho aikarupyasya autsargikatvat. Because karya and the karana, the cause and effect always are similar. So there is always a similarity between the cause and effect. Just as the clay and the pot. So we find the same qualities in the pot as we find in the clay. And similarly also, if the sun is the karya of the effect, we should expect to find in the sun the same kind of qualities that we should find in the cause, namely three elements, which we do find. Therefore we say that the sun is the effect and the three elements are the cause. So atascha mandalatma savita bhutatraya karya madhya bhavati pradhanam karya pradhanam. And so among the products of the three elements, sun becomes the pradhanam, the principal effect. कार्यकरणयोः ऐकरूप्यस्य औत्सर्गकत्वात्. सो द कार्य एंड करण शुड हैव द सेम फॉर्म, मीनिंग सेम कैरेक्टरिस्टिक शुड बी देयर. औत्सर्गकत्वात्, दैट्स अ जनरल रूल. उत्सर्ग इज द जनरल रूल. देयर कुड बी एक्सेप्शंस, बट देन जनरल रूल इज दैट द कॉज एंड इफेक्ट. द एक्सेप्शंस विल बी शोन इन मुंडक उपनिषद इटसेल्फ. यथा सतः पुरुषात् केशलोमानि. जस्ट एज फ्रॉम अ कॉन्शियस बीइंग. So normally you would expect that from the conscious person, the effects also should be conscious. But then the hair, you know, then the hair that which come out from this body are the products of the conscious being, but they are inert. And the nails and things like that, you know. So there are exceptions. Utsarga, the general rule is there, because the question is, how come Brahman is conscious and you say Brahman is the cause of the creation? And creation is jada, inert. You know, the things are inert. and Brahman the cause is conscious. How can conscious Brahman give rise to inert effect? So just as the conscious person can give rise to the inert nails and hair, etc., you know, something like that. So the idea is that there is an utsarga, all right, there could be an exception also. And so Vashya says, Sarishthascha. So it is Saratamah. It is these three elements have predominantly gone into making up of the orb of the sun, as we said. Again, Sadananda Giri, Mandalam Ched Adhidevikam Karyam Kim Punaha Tathavidham Karanamidi. Alright, if you say that, this Mandala is the Adhidevikam Karyam. Isn't that is a subtle body made up of? If the gross body is a product of these three elements, where the two elements are secondary, so what is the what is that makes up the subtle body?
Yattu, Subhashakara says, Yattu Adhidaivikam Karanam Mandalasya Abhyantaram Tadvakshyamaha. Yattu adhidaivikam karanam.
However, that which is this adhidaivikam karyam, this is a cosmic effect. So that which is the cosmic subtle body. So this is a cosmic gross body that we talked about as far as regards the cosmic subtle body.
Mandalasya abhyandaram, that is within the mandalam or within the solar orb, tadvakshyamaha, that we will now say presently, that is what we will presently state. Agrimam amurta vakya iti sheshaha.
In the following vakya, in the following passage, we will now talk about how the subtle body, the cosmic subtle body is formed. This passage told us how the cosmic gross body is formed from the five elements, of which the three elements are predominant. What makes it gross body? Because it is murtam, has distinct avayava. It is martyam, it is perishable. Sthitam, parichinnam, limited. And sat, meaning it is manifest. So that is why it is called gross. And the three elements also are like that. So the three elements give rise to the gross body, which is represented by the orb of the sun.
Again, footnote 9 is there. Aikarupyasyeti samana dharma vatvasya ityartha. So,
so samana dharmatvam, the kari and the karana should possess these similar attributes.
Asticha ubhayatra murtadhitraste anvayatvam.
And we find also in the three elements as well in the orb of the sun, these four aspects are found in both of them.
Chatha chauktam vartake chatushtayanvayadesha bhutatrayrasasmutaha.
So because we find the anvaya for the same vakya, so because we find all the four aspects visible in the sun, therefore we say that it is the rasa of the three elements.
Okay. Then says Anandagiri, Adhidaivikam murtam abhidaya tadrugeva amurtam patikopadana purvakam sphutayavi.
Adhidaivikam murtam abhidaya. Abhidaya having stated. Murtam the gross. Adhidaivikam the cosmic. So having stated how the cosmic gross body is formed,
tadrugeva adhidaivikameva.
Tadrug means adhidaivikameva amurtam pratikopadana purukam spurevi. Now further says how the subtle, the cosmic subtle body is made.
Pratika is the first words. Upadana purukam sputayadi. Amurta vakyasya tatparyam prakashayadi.
So bring about the tatpar, the purport of the following passage, third khandika.
Atha amurtam vayuschantariksham cha etad amurtam etad yata etat yata tasya etasya amurtasya etasya amurtasya etasya yataha एतस्यत्यस्य एष रसः य एष एतस्मिन् मण्डले पुरुषः त्यस्य ह्येष रसः इत्यधिदैवतम् अथ अमूर्तम् देन् नाउ विल् टाक् अबौट् अमूर्तम् विच् इस् सटल् विच् इस् निरवयवम् सो मूर्तम् मीन्स् हेविङ्ग् लिम्स् सो मूर्छित अवयव सो देवर् हेविङ्ग् वेरि वेल् डिफैन्ड् लिम्स् दिस् काल् मूर्तम् सो देट्स् वै वि काल् मूर्ति मूर्ति इस् देट् विच् इस् वेल् डिफैन्ड् लिम्स् सो मूर्तम् आल्सो इस् हेविङ्ग् वेल् डिफैन्ड् लिम्स् वट् इस् अमूर्तम् विच् डसन्ट् हेव् लिम्स् निरवयवम् विच् इस् फार्म्लेस् वायुश्च अन्तरिक्षम् च सो वायु एर् डसन्ट् हेव् एनी लिम्स् The antariksha space also does not have any limbs. Formless, doesn't have form. They do not have form, both of these. Tat amrutam, that is immortal. So, etat amrutam, etat yat. Yat means what? Moving, going, vyapi, pervasive. It is immortal, it is pervasive. Etat tyat. Tyat means what? Unmanifest. So, sat is manifest or formed and tyat is unformed or unmanifest. So this amurtam, or that which is formless or subtle, is also amrutam, it is immortal, and it is pervasive, and it is unformed or unmanifest. Tasya etasya amurtasya etasya amrutasya etasya yataha etasya tyasya. So same fashion, you know, I mean, as same style that was followed in the previous kandika, when said all these four aspects of the two elements, again five elements, and with these two elements are predominant and three elements are subsidiary. So all the four aspects go into making of what we call the subtle body of the sun. How much time was he spending with sun, you know, with nature? But with sun is attracted a lot of attention. Sun stands for all the energies, because therefore, generally speaking, sun is looked upon as prana, the cosmic energy. And sun is of course the cosmic eye. So we find that here also the adhyatmika, generally speaking, when we say that the cosmic person dwells in the sun and energizes the whole creation, illumines the whole creation, watches the whole creation, also the creation is emerged from the sun. So he is a creator, sustainer, resolver. That's how sun is looked upon as God, the universal consciousness. And therefore we say that the individual consciousness also resides in the eye. Of the two eye, the right eye. Because sometimes we say the moon and the sun are the eyes of the Lord. The moon is the left eye, the sun is the right eye. And so predominantly the consciousness is said to reside in the right eye of the person. That's how the meditations are also prescribed. The conscious being who is in the right eye is the conscious being who is in the sun. The individual consciousness is a universal consciousness, because in consciousness there is no distinction. The individuality and the totality being only the ideas, you know, but really the content is the same. That's how the meditations are also prescribed. So, tasya etasya amurtasya etasya amrutasya etasya yataha etasya tyasya, all the six cases. So, of that which is amurtam, that which is amrutam, that which is yat, and that which is tyat, eshaha rasaha, this is the essence. Which one is that? Eshaha etasmin mandale purusha. Earlier it was said, eshaha tapati, the one that shines. Now what does this say? Yaha is etaha, I mean etasmin, eshaha, etasmin mandale purushaha. The person who is there in the solar orb. So, therefore that person is looked upon as vyahruti atma sometimes, you know. Bhuhu, bhuvaha, suvaha. These three vyahrutis make up the body of that sun. Bhuhu is one word. Bhuvaha, two letters. Bhuhu, one letter. Bhuvaha, two letters. Suvaha, also two letters. So, bhuhu is the head. Bhuvaha, the hands. Suha, the legs, and that's how the body of that the person in the sun is there. So different ways these meditations are prescribed, because In the olden days, they were so familiar with these Vyahutis, with Gayatri and with everything else, because that is what they were repeating all the time. And so with reference to that, the meditations are prescribed. Anyway, yeshaetasmin mandale purushaha tasyahi purushaha tyasyahi eshaha rasaha. Because that purusha, the subtle person who is there, is a rasa, the essence of all the four aspects of these two elements. Iti adhidaivatam. So this is the instruction with reference to the cosmic being. Says Vashyakara, atha amurtam. So this is pratika. This atha amurtam are the two first words of the kandika. It is called pratika. That's why pratikopadanapurukam sputayati. First Vashyakara takes the pratika and then explains. Atha adhuna amurtam uchyate vayuschantariksham cha yat parisheshitam bhutadvayam edadamrutam amurtatvat asthitam atah aviruddhyamanam kenachid amrutam amarana dharmi. So atha adhuna amurtam uchyate. So having stated the adhidaivika, the gross aspect, now the adhidaivika, subtle aspect is being stated. So that is the tatparya, that is how the uchyate. So the tatparya of this kandika is explained first. Vayuscha antariksham cha. The vayu and antariksha are the amurtam. Yet parisheshitam bhutadvayam. So having the three elements mentioned earlier, the remaining two elements form what we call the subtle body. Bhutadvayam. Brahmanorubam taduchyate iti sheshaha. So yet parisheshitam. Bhutadvayam brahmanorubam taduchyate iti sheshaha. So now what remains to be stated as far as the form of Brahma is concerned, because murtam cha, amurtam cha, there are two. Dvevava brahmano rupe. Two are the rupa, or two are the forms of Brahma. The murtam and amurtam. The murta when stated, amurtam now is going to be stated. So etad amurtam. It's interesting how these two elements, vayu and the space, are looked upon as amurtam. So they are looked upon as immortal, comparative, relatively speaking. Why is it so? Amurtatvat, niramsatvat. Because there is no avayava, there is no amsha. Like this, which is made of earth, you know, the gross object here, is a composite entity made up of so many components. Therefore you can cut it and divide it into different components. Like this cloth also is made of components, like this strand, you know, the yarn, and so you can separate it. But space is not made of any components, so you can't separate, you cannot divide it, you cannot cut it. Or the air also is not made up of any avayava or any limbs or any components that way, and therefore also you cannot cut and divide air. So that is why, say, amurtatvat. So niramsatvat. So etat amrutam, these two are immortal in a relative sense. Amurtatvat, because there is no amsha or the avayava. And asthitam. Asthitam is what? Aparichinnam, and also aparichinnam, not limited to a place. So says Anandagiri, that amurtatvam ubhayatra hetutvena sambandhyate. So amrutam, amurtatvat, asthitam, amurtatvat. Because it is niramsham, it is without any form or without any avayava of the limbs, therefore it is immortal and therefore also not confined to a place. See, that which is formed, an element, avayava, is always confined to a space. This doesn't have a form and therefore not confined to a space. Asthitam. So aparichinnam. Ataha avirdhimanam kenachita. They are unopposed to anything. See, so this one that is a form. Opposition means what? It does not admit of the other. This has a form, meaning has its own distinct or defined boundaries. And therefore, and this is another object which has its own form or defined boundaries. Now each one does not admit of the other. So it was said that when this one goes into that, it must be destroyed. In the sense that it cannot remain what it is if it has to become this. Or get into this, merge into this. Because each one has a distinct boundary, distinct characteristic, and therefore each one does not admit the other, each one limits the other. Whereas space doesn't have a distinct boundary of its own, and therefore it is unopposed to. It can accommodate anything without opposing that. So space accommodates every object without opposing. And air also, similarly, air also accommodates everything, assumes any form. Since this thing is sort of, you know, it has its own distinct form, so it can't change. Cannot assume another form. While air doesn't have that. Air can assume any form. And space is even subtler. Therefore it is said, avirudhyamanam kenachida. So it is asthitam. Since it is not confined to a particular place or not confined to a particular boundary, put it this way, therefore it is pervasive. It is unopposed to kenachit avirudhyamanam, unopposed to anything. So aparichinnatvam avirodhe hetuhu ataha. Asthitam aparichinnam, therefore it is avirudhyamanam kenachit, unopposed to anything. That's the reason why the other thing cannot destroy it. If space were opposed to this, then this can destroy it by colliding with it, you know. So thing can collide with the other and hurt or destroy other if they are opposed to each other. But the space is not opposed to this, therefore this cannot collide with it. Or air also is not opposed to this, therefore there cannot be collision or there cannot be any kind of... That's why one cannot destroy the other. Neither will space destroy this, nor will this thing destroy the space. Aradna avidhumanam kenachat. Then amritam amaranadharmi. Tatparyam abhidaya aksharathamaha amritam ityadena. So first tatparya is stated. So then the word meanings are given subsequently. Amrita means what? Amarana dharmi, meaning that which is not subject to death, which is imperishable. So that is how vayu is said to be the samvarga, that which absorbs everything. Everything gets absorbed in vayu. The earth gets absorbed in water, the water gets absorbed in fire. When the cosmic dissolution takes place, this is how the absorption takes place. And ultimately everything gets absorbed in vayu. And vayu doesn't get absorbed because it is unopposed to others. Of course, you can say vayu also gets absorbed in air, you know, I mean in the space, and then that is all the space. But there, in the samvarga vidya, the vayu is said to absorb everything because everything goes into prana. Prana itself doesn't have a form, and therefore it is all pervasive. So amrutam amarana dharmi. Therefore, this amrutam or the subtle is imperishable. Just by applying the criterion of what makes a given thing perishable, that's all. The criterion for why something becomes perishable is because it is formed, because it is confined, and because therefore it cannot give up its, you know, it give up its form, etc. And that's why when collided with something, it will perish. Such things are not there in what we call the subtle elements, therefore they are. So in that sense, they are said to be imperishable, that's all. Inasmuch as this possesses certain characteristics which makes it perishable, those characteristics being absent, therefore we call it imperishable. That's all. Not that it is Brahman or something. Okay, then continuing further. Etadyata sthita viparitam vyapi aparichinnam yasmat etat anyebhyah apravibhajyamana visesham ataha tyaditi parokshabhidhanarhameva. पूर्ववत। सो अमरण धर्मी एतद् यत्, सो अगेन इट इज यत्, यत् मीन्स व्हाट, सो स्थित विपरीतम्, सो स्थितम एंड यत्, एज यू सेड यत् इज द प्रेजेंट पार्टिसिपल ऑफ द रूट या, मीन्स टू गो, सो दैट विच इज गोइंग और दैट मीन्स दैट विच इज मूविंग, दैट वन इज मोशनलेस अगेंस्ट दिस इज मूविंग, मूविंग मीन्स व्हाट, दैट विच इज रीचिंग एवरीवेयर, सो रीचिंग व्यापी, इट इज रीचिंग एवरीथिंग, स्थित विपरीतम, सो दैट इज अपोज टू दैट विच इज स्टेशनरी एंड व्यापी अपरिच्छिन्नम, एंड देयरफॉर इट इज फ्री फ्रॉम एनी काइंड ऑफ अ बाउंड्री और लिमिटेशन। यस्मादेतत् अन्येभ्यः अप्रविवज्यमान विशेषम्, यस्मात् एतत् एतत् भूतद्वयम्, सिंस दिस टू एलिमेंट्स अन्येभ्यः पृथिव्यादिभ्यः, सो फुट नोट 7, अन्येभ्यः पृथिव्यादिभ्यः अप्रविवज्यमानः व्यावृतत्वेन अप्रत्यायितो विशेषः साधारणधर्मस्य वायवादेः तत्तथा। See, Bhashyakara says, yasmad etat anyebhya aprabhivajyaman visesham. As we said, each one of these elements, fire, water and earth, can be distinguished from the other. And there were prabhivajyaman visesham. Each one has distinguishing characteristics, whereas these two other elements do not have characteristics that distinguish them from the others. So you can't separate space from other things, nor can you separate air from other things in that sense. अप्रविभज्यमान विशेषम अतः त्यदिति परोक्ष अभिधानार्हम्, therefore they are called त्यत् means तत् meaning always referred to as परोक्ष, something that is not evident, these three elements are evident, these two elements are referred to as that which is not evident। पूर्वतः like before, so just as that all the four aspects were mentioned, the four aspects we mention here also। Now going to footnote number 7, anyebhyah prasivyadibhyah aprayabhajyamanah vyavrutatvena apratyayitah visheshah asadharanadharmayasya vayavadehi tattatha. So in short, the vayu and the antariksha are these two which do not possess any asadharanadharma. See, this one possesses asadharanadharma, has this particular color, which distinguishes from this object with another color. See, every object must have color. All the formed objects must have color. Anything that is formed must have color, which distinguishes it from other formed objects which have their color. That's how you know the form anyway, because of color. How do you know the boundary of this object? Because of this color. How do you know the boundary of this object? Because of its color. The boundary of any object for that matter, because of the color. So form and color go together. And that's why this possesses the characteristics that distinguish it from these other ones. That's how we are able to distinguish one object from the other. So, one object made of the three elements can distinguish from another object made of the same three elements because each one possesses its distinguishing characteristics. Whereas, one vayu cannot be distinguished from another vayu, or the vayu cannot be distinguished from the other three elements also, or the space that way. So the footnotes are vyavrutatvena apratyayitah visheshah asadhanadharmah. So you are not able to see vayu as something separate from the other elements. So this one creates in me a pratyaya, creates in me a cognition that this is different from microphone, you know. But similarly, vayu does not create in me a cognition that it is different from others. And so, tattatha पृथिव्यादीनां मंडलमिव वायुआकाशयो विशेष अभिव्यंजक कार्य भावादि भावः। सो पृथ्वी एटसेट्रा, दिस थ्री एलिमेंट्स हैव गिवन राइज टू व्हाट वी कॉल द सोलर ऑर्ब व्हिच इज अ डिस्टिंक्ट एंटिटी, वेयर इज वायु एंड अंतरिक्ष हैव नॉट गिवन राइज टू विजिबल और अ परसेप्टिबल प्रोडक्ट, सो दे आर ऑल्सो नॉट परसेप्टिबल बिकॉज दे हैव नॉट गिवन राइज टू अ प्रोडक्ट दैट इज परसेप्टिबल। तत्कार्यम ही करणात्मा सचन प्रत्यक्ष मंडलांतर्गत, एंड सो द वायु एंड अंतरिक्ष आल्सो नॉट प्रत्यक्ष, नॉट परसेप्टिबल टू द आईज, एंड द पुरुष द सटल बॉडी ऑफ द सूर्य दैट इज मेड ऑफ देम आल्सो इज नॉट प्रत्यक्ष, Therefore, it is referred to as tyat or tat. So, it is referred to as that. Paroksha. So, therefore, Bhashyakara said, Paroksha Abhidhanarham Eva. And therefore, this is Paroksha Abhidhanarham. And so, this Purusha is Paroksha Abhidhanaramurtam. Is referred to as something that is remote, something that is indirect, or something that is not perceptible. Is there, but not perceptible. So, what is Purvata? Says Anandagiri, Amurtatvadinam mitho vishesha vishesha bhavaha hetu hetumat bhavascha yathaishtam drashtavyah. Vashyakara explained in an earlier passage how murtam is the reason for martyam, is the reason for siddham, is the reason for sat, and vice versa. So, there is a, Vashyakara explained the hetu hetumat bhav, each one becomes the cause for the other. And Vishesha and Vishesha Bhava, the adjective, the attribute of the other, Yathaishtam Drashtavya. You can see it, you know, as you like, because it obtains there. Similarly, also, we should see that kind of relationship obtaining between these four. What? Amurtam and Amrutam and Yat and Tyat. But among these four also, we should see the Karyakaran Bhava or Vishesha and Vishesha Bhava. So, Mitra means mutual, parasparam. Visheshana Vishesha Bhava Hetu Hetu Madhavascha Yatheshtam Drashtavidyaha Purvata Vashyakara says, like before. So doesn't see the need of explaining that here. Although it has been explained, Amurtatvats, Vashyakara already explained, Amrutam, it is immortal. Why? Amurtatvats, because it doesn't have a form. Therefore it is Asthitam, therefore it is not confined to a boundary. And therefore Tyat, therefore is not evident, and therefore available only for being mentioned as something that is remote. So it has been explained also.
Punaratyabhi purvata.
And so, etasya, amurtasya, etasya, amurtasya, etasya, sthitasya, etasya, yataha, etasya, tyasya. All of this punaratya also is to be understood that all the four aspects of the two elements is one of the making up of the subtle body of the sun and not just one of them. That's what footnote number 18 says. Purvadati. Visheshana chatushtayavataha bhutadvayasya faraguktasya punaruktihi kimidi krita iti yukte mandala purushasya chaturvida visheshanaka bhutadvaya karyatvam naike karyata iti vaktum punaruktihi adhikoktehe adhikasatvadityasa, as we discussed yesterday. So, Visheshana Chatushtayavataha Bhutadvayasya, these two elements, space and the air, which are possessed of these four kinds of Visheshana or attributes. Raguktasya Punaruktihi Kimidi Krita. Why is it Punarukti, meaning why the same thing is repeated? So, it was said earlier, why is it repeated? It is said, Etasya, Amurtasya, Etasya, Amrutasya, etc. Iti Yukte, Mandala Purushasya, Chaturvida Visheshanaka Bhutadvaya Karyatvam Na Ekaikam Karyata Iti. That the subtle body of the Surya is made up of all the four aspects of the two elements and not just any one aspect. Iti Vaktum Punaruktihi. To emphasize that or clarify that is a Punarukti. Adhikoktehe Adhikasatvat. Since something she said again, therefore it must have some extra meaning also. It cannot be simply repetition. It is not simply a repetition, it must necessarily convey some more sense. And that's why this is the sense that we get. Okay, then continuing. Bhashyakara Purvat. Tasya etasya amurtasya etasya amurtasya etasya yataha etasya tyasya chatushtay visheshanasya amurtasya esha rasah kosau ya eshah etasmin mandale purushah karanatmakah hiranyagarbhah pranah ityabhidhiyate yaha saha eshah amurtasya bhutadvayasya rasah पूर्ववत सारिष्ठः। सो पूर्व लाइक अर्लियर तस्य एतस्य अमूर्तस्य एतस्य अमूर्तस्य एतस्य यतः एतस्य त्यस्य, द रीजन फॉर रिपीटिंग एज वी सेड इज टू मेक श्योर टू कन्वे दैट ईच वन ऑफ दीज फोर एस्पेक्ट्स हैज गॉन इन मेकिंग ऑफ द सटल बॉडी ऑफ द सन। चतुष्टय विशेषणस्य, सो चतुष्टय विशेषणस्य, सो चतुष्टयम् विशेषणम् सो येषाम् तानि भूतानि, सो दिस चतुष्टय दिस फोर आर द विशेषण ऑफ दिस एलिमेंट्स दोज हैव गॉन इनटू मेकिंग ऑफ द सटल बॉडी ऑफ द सन। अमूर्तस्य समूर्तम्, सो चतुष्टयम् विशेषणम् यस्य तत् अमूर्तम् समूर्तम्, सो द सटल विच हैज दिस फोर एट्रीब्यूट्स द क्वालिफिकेशंस अमूर्तस्य भूतद्वयस्य द टू एलिमेंट्स, सो एषः रसः, सो of these two elements this is the rasa. What? The subtle body of the sun is the rasa or the essence of these two elements, space and air. Kosa rasah, which is the rasa? Yeshah etasmin mandale purushah, so one that is the purusha, the person, the subtle body in the solar orb. Karanatmakah, so solar orb is what? Karyatmaka. The solar orb which is visible is karyatmaka, meaning of the nature of the body. Karanatmaka of the nature of the subtle body is the result of the two elements. So karanatmaka, footnote number 11, samashtyantah karana swarupah nanavichetah iti dhyayam samashtyantah karana swarupah. So subtle body, as we said, the sun represents the whole cosmos. So body of the sun represents the cosmic body. And the mind of the sun represents the cosmic mind. The subtle body of the sun represents the cosmic subtle body. And therefore, samashtyantah krana swarupah, the totality of all the whole mind is the mind of the sun, which is made up of the two elements, space and air. Yesha etasmin mandale purushah करणात्मक है, हिरण्यगर्भ है, प्राण है, which is also called हिरण्यगर्भ है, called प्राण। Again, not so, it is said also, न आयम अभी चेतन इति ध्येयम्, understand that, this is not the consciousness, it is just the instrument. So, we have the consciousness, we have a karana, or an instrument, and we have karya, a body. So, this should be understood as the karana, and not चेतना. Someone says it is चेतना, therefore it is said it is not चेतना. And why it is not Chaitana will be explained also. Yah saha eshaha amurtasya bhutadvayasya rasaha. So again, purvata, as we explained earlier, so how the gross aspect of the sun, because it is gross, where we see also the form, where we also see the confinement, we also see the manifestation, which are the peculiarities of the three elements, which we see in the aura of the sun, therefore we say that it is the essence of the three elements. Similarly also, what are the peculiarities of the two elements? That they are formless, that they are not confined, that they are not evident or manifest. And that is what we find in the subtle body of the sun. Therefore we say that it is saraha, or the essence of these two elements. And all the four characteristics of the two elements have gone into making up of that subtle body. So purvat sarishtaha. That's what I am saying. Yatha bhutatrayasya mandalam sarishtamuktam tadvada. So just as it was explained how the mandalam is the essence of the bhutatraya. Similarly, sarishyatvanudya hetumanah, reiterating that it is essence, again the hetu etam etati. So Vashyakara says, and number 22. Etat purushasaram cha amurtam भूतद्वयम् हैरण्यगर्भलिङ्गारम्भायहि भूतद्वयाभिव्यक्तिः अव्याकृतात् तस्मात् तादर्थ्यात् सारं भूतद्वयम्। एतत् पुरुष सारं च अमूर्तम्। अगेन फुटनोट नंबर 12 सेज बहुव्रीहि एतत् पुरुष सारं। एतत् पुरुष सारं, पुरुष है सार है, सो येषां ते सो पुरुष साराणि सो अमूर्त। All these two elements, as a matter of fact, are those of which the Purusha or the person in the solar orb is Sara, the essence. Amurtam, Bhutadvayam, these two elements. So why do we say that? Hairanyagarvalingaram bhahi Bhutadvayabhivyakti avyakrata. Somehow this is an interesting, you know. So this Hetu is given. Why do you say that these two elements are made up the subtle body? So Hairanyagarvalingaram bhahi. Hiranyagarbhalinga. Linga means subtle body. So Arambha means for creation. So for creating the subtle body of Hiranyagarbha, Bhutadvayabhivyaktihi avyaktat. So in the beginning of the creation, what is there is avyakta, the unmanifest. From this unmanifest, the five elements emerge. In the beginning of these five elements, the two elements space and air are predominant, and the other three elements are subsidiary, and they have emerged specifically to form this subtle body of Hiranyagarbha. And then they undergo a mutual combination to form the gross body of Hiranyagarbha. So we say that the reason why we say that the Purusha, or the person in the sun, is the essence, is because these two elements have been specifically manifest from the unmanifest in order to form the subtle body of Hiranyagarbha. So Hiranyagarbha Lingarambhaya, footnote number 10, Hiranyati Lingatma, meaning the Lingatma means the subtle body of the Hiranyagarbha. For formation of that, these two elements are manifest from the unmanifest. So Avyaktat, meaning Karana, the Ishvara, from Ishvara, these two elements made manifest specifically to form the subtle body of the sun. तस्मात् तादर्थ्यात्, तस्मात् तादर्थ्यात्, तादर्थ्यात् इस फुटनोट 16, मंडल अधिष्ठात्र पुरुषे करणात्मनि अमूर्त अमूर्त यत्राम चतुर्णाम अन्वयः अपरः हेतुः द्रष्टव्यः। दैट्स ओके। सो तादर्थ्यात्, तादर्थ अनिर्देशेस तादर्थ्यात् भूतद्वयस्य भूतत्रयोपसर्जनस्य स्वयं प्रधानस्य Hiranyagarbhaarambhartatvadityavadam. In as much as the two elements were manifest specifically for forming the subtle body of the sun, so these two elements combined with other three elements which are not predominant, Swayam Pradhanasya, so that these two elements are actually predominant, so these two elements are meant specifically for making the subtle body of the sun. Therefore, Tatsaram Bhutadvayam, therefore we say that this subtle body of the sun is the sar or the essence of these two elements. Nothing new is being stated, I mean the same stuff is stated in. So just as the three elements went into making of the gross body, the two elements go into making of the subtle body. The same logic is presented here. There is nothing new. So, but so many footnotes are given, you know, and so much explanation is given that you think that something new is there, and everybody feels that what's going on, you know. But the same thing, there's nothing different here. The three elements make up the gross body of the sun, the two elements make up the subtle body of the sun. Because we find similarity. The three elements consist of, have these four characteristics, which four characteristics are evident in the orb of the sun. The two elements of these four characteristics, amurtam, etc., which are the characteristics which are in the subtle body of the sun. Then we say that the three elements have gone into making of this, the two elements have gone into making of the subtle body of the sun. That's as simple as that. But Shruti also repeats, you know, just to make sure that there is no scope for any misunderstanding. So Bhashyakar also explains, you know, and so Tikakar also explains, then Tippanikar also explains. They keep on writing big paragraphs, you know, for stating Purvat should have been enough. Purvat means as before. That would have been simple actually. But when we read so much, you know, then it looks like this is something different. And then a lot of Sanskrit is there, a lot of Hetus are there, and so it seems to be very complicated. In fact, it is simple that way. So, hetum avatarya vyachaste. Again, so what is the, so hetu, again like that, you know, the last kandika also stated the hetu, so this kandika also. So, satohi esha rasaha, it says, tyatohi esha rasaha, tyasyahi esha rasaha. So, this is the rasa, same thing. So, that's what Bhashya says on the page 547. Tyasyahi esha rasaha yasmat yo mandalastah purushah mandalavat nagruhyade sarascha bhutadvayascha tasmadasti mandalasthasya purushasya bhutadvayascha cha sadharmyam tasmad yuktam prasiddhavat hetu upadanam tyasya hyesha rasaide. So it's the same explanation. Tyasya hi esha rasaha. Tyas means unmanifest. Means all the four are to understood here. Amurtam, amrutam, and then yat, and then tyat. So all of these, this is the rasa, the essence of the all the four characteristics of two elements is this. Va yasmadiva mandalastha purusha mandalvat na grihyate. So mandalam we are able to perceive, but the purusha, the subtle body of the sun, we cannot perceive. Just as the three elements we can perceive, the two elements we cannot perceive. And so the similar characteristic, the characteristic the two elements have, are the characteristic of the person in the solar orb. Therefore sarasya bhutadvayasya, and therefore it is sara, the essence of the bhutadvaya, the two elements, space and air. Tasmad asti mandalasthasya purushasya bhutadvayasya sadharmyam. So there is sadharmyam, similarity in the characteristics of the two elements as well as the subtle body of the sun. Tasmad yuktam prasiddhvat hetupadanam. Therefore, like it is something very already known to us, tyasyahi eshah rasaha. Similar thing was stated earlier also. So, satahi eshah rasaha, tyasyahi eshah rasaha. As though it is very evident, so it is stated by the Shruti. Okay. So this is how Bhashyakara explains these kandikas. However, Sri Rana is Swamatamuktva Bhartra Prabhanchamatamaha. So we know at least two commentators who have commented upon the Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, who are mentioned here. One is Bhartru Prapancha, other is Bhatta Bhaskara. So, these two. Not Bhartru Hari, but Bhartru Prapancha. So, Bhartru Hari is different. Of course, there are more than one Bhartru Hari also, perhaps, you know. Bhartru Hari must be also a like, name like Janaka. Because Bhartru Hari has done so much, you know. But anyway. So, Bhartru Prapancha is... They must have the text. I don't know, the text may be available also, I do not know. I thought the text is not available, but text could have been available. I don't think it is available to us. But it is available to the commentators also. Anandagiri also refers to that, because Anandagiri, as we will see, refers to a passage from the Bhartru Prapancha commentary. And of course, the Vartikara refers to it. But to us, these commentaries, as best as I know, are not available. And Bhatta Bhaskara commentary also. And therefore the only thing that we know about those commentaries is what Bhashyakara and the Tikakaras mention about them. Just as Pani also mentions so many grammarians. We think that Pani is the first grammarian? No. Pani mentions so many grammarians himself. Except that's all we know, that such grammars were, grammarians were there. As to whether grammars were there, we do not know. But definitely grammarians were there, having their specific opinions. And where they are acceptable to Panini, he mentions them. Where they are not acceptable also, he will mention them. Because people already know them. So when something is well known, then you must account for it. Either saying that what is well known is right, or saying that what is well known is not right, and giving reason why it is not right. So when Bhashyakara now has given an explanation like this, so main point that Bhashyakara has made is, that this solar orb stands for the cosmic gross body, which is the product of the three elements, with the two elements in subsidiary, and that there is a subtle body also corresponding to the sun, and that is the primary product of the two elements, and that is the cosmic subtle body. This is the explanation Bhashyakara has given. Then all this neti will make sense. See, after all this is stated here, is negated subsequently. That Brahman is not this, Brahman is not this. Whereas Bhartrupapanja says that the three elements make up what we call the solar robe, and now Purusha, that this passage mentions, yaha etasmin mandale Purusha. So Purusha should mean conscious being, which is generally the case. The word Purusha is used for a conscious being. And this Kandika also says, Purusha etasmin mandale Purusha. And so the Purusha that obtains in the sun. Therefore, Bhartrupapanja has interpreted the word Purusha as a conscious being. And so he is the cause, etc. And he has given that explanation. But if he is the consciousness, then you cannot negate that. Brahman, you cannot say Brahman is not consciousness. Brahman is not subtle body, Brahman is not gross body. That is right. But to say Brahman is not consciousness is not right. Therefore, this should refer to what is to be negated. In short, Deva Brahmano Rupe, these two rupa, the characteristics of Brahma are there. So they are the two characteristics of only Saguna Brahma or Sopadikam Brahma, from which the Upadhi is to be negated by the process of Apavada, then alone we come up with the Nirupadikam Brahman. And so all of this discussion is within the range of Upadhi. Within the range of Upadhi, and therefore here Bhartrupapanchat all of a sudden says that this Purusha refers to a consciousness.